All right. So we're going to discuss two final things about functions in JavaScript, and that's going to lead us into talking about objects. So with functions, we've learned how to return values, how to just process stuff, and then also how to request and also send through in a function call parameters. One last thing that we need to discuss is that you can have nested functions. And so I'm going to go ahead and create a function called print both. And in here, we're just going to console log phrase and another concatenated into one. So console log phrase, another. There we go. So at this point, what's going to happen, as you guys can see that we've created the get phrase length method. Let's actually change this to get phrase and then print both. Now, what's going to happen is let's say I pass in P1 and P2. Let's just save this and refresh for now. It's going to say get phrase length is not defined because we changed the method name. Let's name this computed just because that makes a little more sense. Then let's refresh there. And it still does the same thing. This is a slightly longer sentence, so it prints out the first one. Let's remove that. So what it does is it first gets the length of the first phrase, and then if the second parameter is not undefined, then it's going to add the second parameter's length to the first one. We declare a function and then we return the length. So I'm going to save this and refresh, and as you can see, we get 61. Not sure why break is pointed in there or printed in there, but yeah. So we've created a function inside a function, and we're going to use that. So if I were to access this like this and say print both, save it. It doesn't do anything. And that's because the function there is scoped. If I tried to print it as a variable, also, it's. Let me go ahead and return. Save, refresh. That's what I want to do. So if you think that I would be able to access that method in any way from outside the get phrase function, that's what I'm demonstrating that you cannot do. So in this instance, what you can do is we're not going to try and access the method when we call the method. Okay, we can't do that, but we can access the method from within the method. So I'm gonna space there and then another. So we're concatenating these two phrases into one. We're separating them by a space. So what we can do is in the get phrase method, we can then return print both. So I'm going to save this now and I'm going to refresh. As you can see, we've returned from a nested function the value of this nested function to wherever we call get phrase. So again, we're going to go down here and kind of see what's happening. Let me remove some of that. All right, so we define this method, and then let's not worry about that right now. And then we define a parameter one and a parameter two, and then we set computed, which is a variable, equal to get phrase, and we pass in parameter one and parameter two. So at this point, what this does is it jumps back up here, it reads this function, says, okay, inside the function parameter one is going to be phrase, and parameter two is going to be another. And then it starts processing. So we get the length of the item. If this isn't defined, we add that length, and then we declare another function called print both. Now it doesn't do anything until we call it. So here down here, we return print both. So then it jumps back up here. It's like, okay, well, this is actually what I should return. So I'm going to return that here, which is going to return it here. And then we're going to console log it. This does have real-world applications, and that's if, for instance, you inside of a function need to perform some computation on multiple bits of data. You don't want to rewrite that code. The point of programming is to write once. I mean, that's functional and object-oriented programming. Procedural programming, procedural programming is when you don't use functions or objects, really, and that makes it a little more complicated because every time you want to do something, you have to write it out wherever you are in the code. So that's why we use functions. Same thing here, it's just this is slightly smaller scope. Now, what happens if we don't want to pass in that variable, but we want to pass in that variable? So what we'll do is we'll take parameter 2, we'll pass that in. In Python, you can do something like this. It's called keyword arguments. And you can type another equals and then that. So I'm going to save it and refresh. And let me actually return all. So we're not going to be printing both for this. We're just returning the length, and we get 27. So this length is 27, this length is 34, I believe it was. So we can see that setting another to parameter 2 doesn't, it's not doing anything, it's still passing that in as phrase. So what, I mean, and also you think, okay, well, phrase needs to have something, so we can set a default argument of null. Set that. We get a red underline. Now you can definitely do this in Python, and that's part of the reason why Python is such a beautiful language, but we're not learning Python right now, so we need to figure out how to do this and how to make parameters and functions more flexible. And we're going to do that by using an object. So in the method call right here, how we create an object in JavaScript, you just open up your curly braces like that. And now you can make a list, which is kind of like an array. It's going to have a key and a value. So in this case, we're going to set phrase colon, and then we're going to set that to p1. Put a comma, and then another is going to be set to p2. There. This right here, that's an object that has a key and a value, and then another key and another value. So we're going to save this. And what we'll need to do at this point is remove both of these. And we set the incoming variable or the parameter that's incoming to obj. Actually, no, that's a. Let's set it to params. And then in here, we could access params.phrase. And then params.another. Now, if we only wanted to get the length of another, what we have to do, we also have to change this to params.another. Remove that method altogether. That's just making things look more complicated. So let's go ahead and save this and refresh, and we get 62. And that's because what's happening now is this method is like, okay, we're going to take in one parameter called params. So L is going to be equal to params.phrase.length. So this is going to be passed in like this. The parameter 1 is going to become params.phrase inside this function. And then we check if params.another is not undefined. And if that's not undefined, then to the L variable, we add params.another.length. And that's going to add the length of this, because inside the function, this is going to be referred to as params.another. So the whole object is going to be referred to as params, and then to access values within an object, you just put dot and then the name of the value that you want to use. So at that point, we are creating both. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass an empty string into phrase. So the only value we are passing in at this point is another, going to refresh and we get 27. So that is the correct answer that we're looking for. That's the value of that. Now, additionally, I'm going to save this and refresh, and undefined is, params phrase is undefined, so it's going to freak out here. It doesn't know what exactly we're talking about. So we can say if params.phrase we're going to do this. Now the only problem is if params phrase does not exist, then we're not creating a variable because it creates it at this level. So what we need to do at the very top of a function is we declare our variable just like that. We don't assign a value to it yet, we just create it. What we're going to do is use this variable like that. So if params.phrase, then this is going to become that. And then if another is not undefined, then we're going to add that. So I'm going to save this and refresh. We get not a number. That's because that technically does exist. Let me do this. If type of params.phrase doesn't equal undefined, save it, refresh, still get not a number. It's because we didn't set a number. So it wasn't set to become a number and it didn't become a number here. So when this tries to add a length to this, it wasn't a number, so it couldn't do that. So that's a little bit about objects, and we're going to be jumping more into objects in the next video.